Can we use these?
Yeah, they have been cleared by the family.
Do we have any of the auto accident?
No.
Before and after, that's very useful.
That's what I thought. His wife, after the first attack.
He never freaked out before the accident?
No. We think the impact was the sole cause of damage to the brain. It could happen to anybody. In fact, we feel this condition may be extremely common among those people who engage in repeated acts of violence. Certain policemen, gangsters, rioters.
Can I take these?
Yes. Now, nobody ever thinks of these people as physically ill.
I see.
And so we have no idea exactly how common it is, but our guess is that perhaps as much as 1 or 2% of the population may suffer from it. Now, you see, we're talking about 2 to 4 million Americans.
2 to 4 million Americans?
These people are predisposed not only to violent, aggressive behavior, but hypersexuality, pathological intoxication.
Isn't that Paul Newman over there?
Where? No. We had one woman who, during a seizure state, would have intercourse with 12 men in a night and not receive satisfaction.
My God. You think this operation is a cure for that kind of violence?
Yes, we believe so. The operation has not been performed yet on a human being.
I see.
It's extremely sensitive where the press is concerned. For reasons best known to themselves, they become overzealous where psychosurgery is concerned, especially if the patient is a prisoner. Now, we've observed all of the legal niceties. Both Benson and his ex-wife have signed all the papers, but even so, I wouldn't want any leakages before the operation. You understand?
Of course. That's my job. You're doing the operation?
Oh, yes.
Well, we'll have to check your file. Make sure we have a current picture.
We'll get you anything you need. No, I'll take care of it.
right, thank you, gentlemen.
You in charge here?
That's right, I'm Dr. Morris. Can you take those off, please?
I don't have any orders about that.
I guess it's okay.
All right, gentlemen, 17th floor, thank you.
You have to sign for this delivery.
This is Mr. Benson.
All set for him.
You have a time-sharing station up here.
Mm-hmm.
Sanders, 804.
What?
The make of the computer.
Sanders, 804.
Right.
I'll check that.
Just a precaution.
It's okay.
Can I get out now?
Sure.
Do they have to be here?
They can wait outside.
I meant, do they have to be here at all?
Yes, they do.
All the time.
All the time.
This bed will have to be replaced.
Sorry?
And that'll have to go.
Why?
You don't know why?
I'll have the nurse bring you some pajamas.
Tests showed no intracranial bleeding, and he was released from the hospital. 2 months later, the patient began to experience what he called blackouts. These were, in fact, periods of amnesia, and always preceded by a distinct olfactory aura. He consulted his physician, who told him that he was working too hard and recommended that he reduce his alcohol intake. The patient began to realize that the blackouts were becoming more frequent and lasting longer. Sometimes, he would regain consciousness in unfamiliar surroundings.
Yeah.
Are you decent?
On occasion, he had cuts and bruises, torn clothing, suggesting he had been fighting. This was subsequently proven correct. He had, in fact, attacked and tried to kill at least 2 people. There is an added complication. About a year ago, he made what he calls a monumental discovery in his work. Benson is a computer scientist specializing in artificial life, machine intelligence. Apparently, he is brilliant in his field. He claims that he discovered that machines were competing with human beings and that ultimately machines would overtake the world.
Do I scare the pants off you? No?
Events disturbed him sufficiently to seek psychiatric help. On the basis of his history, head injury, episodic violence, paranoia about machines, we decided that the patient is probably suffering from para-epilepsy. Unlike conventional epilepsy, the patient doesn't have physical seizures when cells of the brain misfire, but instead has uncontrollable rages. Because of the failure of these drugs to control these attack rages, this neuropsychiatric unit has considered him a surgical candidate for limbic pacing by implanted computer. There is one alternative, diethyl stilbestrol, a drug that will destroy his testosterone. Before I bring Benson in, I think I should remind you, the patient is highly intelligent.
Many people in there? Standing room only.
There's still time to stop this. Harry, are you sure you want to go through with it?
I'm sure.
I'm against it.
Hello, Mr. Benson.
Dr. McPherson?
We've asked you to come here to answer a few questions for these doctors.
Do I have any choice?
Of course, you have a choice.
Do we have any questions for Mr. Benson, please? Yes?
Mr. Benson, can you tell us more about the smells you have before your blackouts?
Not really.
Well, can you give us some idea?
It's like pig shit and turpentine.
Do these smells always precede a blackout?
Yes.
So you always know when a blackout is coming?
Yes.
What do you feel when a blackout is coming?
Angry. You're very angry. It's like a roller coaster. Once you start it, you can't stop it. Every morning when I get up, the first thing that comes into my head is, will it happen again today? There's no feeling like that in the world.
7 p.m., head shaved. 8 p.m., supper. 9 p.m., lights out. And 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, the operation. Any questions?
What about our meals?
There'll be one or two of you.
One, we're working 8-hour shifts.
Isn't that rather a long time?
Pardon me?
8 hours at a stretch. Isn't that rather a long time? Sitting in a chair?
A limbic brain pacing procedure will put Mr. Benson's brain under the control of a miniature computer, the size of a postage stamp, implanted in his neck. The computer will be powered by an atomic power pack implanted in his shoulder. The connection to the brain will be direct by means of wires inserted in the cortical substance. Once the system is in place, the computer will monitor Benson's brain waves and watch for a seizure starting up. If that happens, it will deliver a tranquilizing shock to abort the seizure. As a result of this procedure, the subject will act the same, with the exception that he will have no further violent attacks. The whole system will be less troublesome to him than wearing a self-winding wristwatch. We have performed this operation successfully on animals 57 times. This will be the first such procedure on a human being.
I'm grateful to Dr. Ellis for reminding us that we are talking about a man. and not an animal. It seems to me that all the technical data so skillfully expounded is mere paper over the cracks. The patient is also a paranoid psychotic who is afraid of machines and afraid that men will be turned into machines. Your operation may exaggerate these feelings.
I understand the objection, Dr.
Let me finish. I frankly feel that if somebody stuck wires in my brain and a computer in my neck and an atomic battery in my shoulder, I'd wonder if I hadn't been turned into a machine.
I see what you're saying.
Let me also remind you of the estimated 50,000 prefrontal lobotomies performed in the 1940s and 50s for all sorts of mental illnesses and brain diseases. They created an unknown number of human vegetables. Vegetables are easier for mental institutions to control.
Now, this is not a lobotomy.
Those operations were also carried out by physicians who were too eager to act. And they were stopped not by Congress, nor the American Medical Association, nor the American Psychiatric Association, but by the development of new tranquilizing drugs.
Mr. Benson has agreed to have this operation.
Dr. Morris?
Harry asked me to bring this.
Okay, I'll see he gets it.
Could I see him?
I'm afraid not.
Just for a few minutes?
He's very heavily sedated.
Oh, could you give him a message then?
Sure.
Tell him I'm back in my old apartment. He'll understand.
Okay, I'll tell him.
You won't forget.
No.
Thanks.
Okay.
Say, what's your name?
Angela Black.
Come in.
Tried to kill two people. If at any time he says that he feels funny or smells something bad, should be respected as indicating the start of a seizure. Under such circumstances, notify the NPS and hospital security at once. One should also remember he is a highly intelligent and sensitive man. He suffers an organic disease which has affected his mental state. Beneath it all, he is frightened and concerned about what is happening to him. Janet Ross, M.D., otherwise known as Miss Warmth.
I think that's him.
This morning.
They're really gonna put wires in his brain?
Sure.
No shit.
Thank you.
Mr. Harold Benson. I'm going to ask you to slide a little to your right. Let's go. All right. How's your mouth feel?
Dry.
Be okay, pal.
In the brain substance, they're using computer assistance. The computer monitors insertion of the electrodes and checks for any placement area. This information is fed into the computer by a comparatively new machine, a scanner that x-rays the patient's brain in layers.
Anytime you want to begin, Dr. Ellis.
Thank you. I think we'll wait for the patient. It's just so you won't fall off. We don't want you to hurt yourself. Iodine, please. Thank you.
Just a stick.
Local anesthetic in this part of the operation. The patient himself is sedated, but awake. Later, when they enter the brain substance, there'll be no need for anesthetic, since the brain cannot feel pain. This fact simplified.
I think we can start now.
X-rays the patient's brain in layers, thus building a three-dimensional view of it, which is in turn fed into the computer.
Our coordinates.
Mm-hmm. Probe number one is lateral 48.1, coronal 21.5. Probe number two, lateral 51.2, coronal 28.7.
Thank you for your consultation.
I think we can begin now.
Operation has begun.
Thank you.
That's enough carpentry for today. I remember old Harbaker in Toronto. He used to assist him. He'd like you to work fast. Yell at us, cut the dirt, cut right in. Act like you're breaking into somebody's tomb. It's only a head. Cut it. No, let's cut the door. Know roughly what part of the brain to shock. It's in the amygdala, a posterior area of the so-called limbic system. But we don't know exactly where. We solve that by implanting a number of electrodes in the brain. Each incision carries 20 electrodes. So in this case, 40 electrodes will be inserted.
This is what psychiatry would be a little ineffective. Janet?
How was that? Patient. You all right, Mr. Benson?
Fine.
Any pain?
No.
Good. Just relax now.
You too, Doctor.
Yeah, this is the only work I know that's boring and nerve-wracking at the same time. Match that. Now let's try the next one. This is more satisfying than psychiatry, eh, Bob?
If you say so.
How deep are we?
3 centimeters.
Halfway home. First half is the toughest. What was that?
We have an alarm.
I won't do. That would end the operation. Probably the patient as well. Okay, I'll back up and correct.
Can we get a correction, please? Okay. Lateral angle reset to 48.1. Correcting nicely.
Surgery is a craft.
practical, real, direct. How are we coming with electronics?
Can we have final checks, please? They're checking them now.
I always was the slowest one. Always was. Slow and steady ones it is. I think we should be... All right, let's set the electronics now. Let's hook him up and then close.
We'll be closing in 10 minutes.
Two 0.5 centimeter incisions made over the right and left temporal regions. And 2 millimeter burr holes drilled with a K7 drill. Implantation of Briggs electrodes carried out with computer assistance on the limbic program. That's spelled L-I-M-B-I-C. Limbic program.
What do you want in?
Vital signs, Q5 minutes to the first hour, Q15 for the second, Q30 for the third, hourly thereafter, and if he's stable, he can go back on the floor in 6 hours.
I assume that you'll put him on Thorazine as soon as he's awake? I haven't heard dialogue like that since I was in grammar school.
Do you want him on Thorazine?
Yes, 200 milligrams initially, and then 100 Q, 4 hours.
The beginning soon.
It's all over, pal.
I'm not kidding you. Eddie watched the whole thing.
He did?
Yeah. That boy won't give us no more trouble.
Nothing. How do you feel?
You know, I'm so concerned. I feel like I'm a time bomb about to go off. What are we going to do today?
We're going to stimulate your electrodes sequentially and see what happens.
Will it hurt?
No.
Okay.
Stimulation series one, patient Harry Benson.
You will feel a variety of sensations. Some of them may be quite pleasant, and I'd like you to tell me how they feel, all right?
Okay.
Electrode one, 5 millivolts for 5 seconds.
That's interesting.
What's interesting?
That feeling.
Can you describe it?
It feels like I'm eating a ham sandwich.
Do you like ham sandwiches?
Not particularly.
Are you hungry?
Not particularly.
What else do you feel?
Nothing, just the taste of a ham sandwich.
On rye.
Let's go to two. Electrode two, 5 millivolts for 5 seconds.
Excuse me.
Where are you going?
I've got to take a terrible leak.
It'll pass.
Are you telling me I don't have to take a leak?
Yes, I am.
Go to three. Electrode three, 5 millivolts for 5 seconds.
He can't do anything, can't put on his shirt, can't put on his shoes, can't play ball. So his parents take him to this private school, and they... So they take him to this private school, you know, and they say, yeah, we can fix him up right away. We teach by the reward method, you know.
Do you feel anything?
No. No subjective change. Go on to seven.
Electrode seven, 5 millivolts, 5 seconds.
Could I have some milk and cookies, please, Mom? Come on, Mom. Bob gets them at home, Mom.
That's interesting. How old would you say?
5, 6 years old at most. What do you want? What do you want?
Goes out, and Doc says, fine, Johnny, he's a ice cream cone. He goes...
Like that.
This guy walks into the men's room, see, and he sees this guy standing there like this. He's going... So he figures the guy's got an affliction. He walks over to him, he says, can I help you? He says, oh, yes, could you unzip my fly?
I feel like I'm burning up.
Thank you.
Electrode 31, 5 millivolts, 5 seconds.
That was nice.
What was?
You can do that one again if you want to.
How does it feel?
You know, you're really a wonderful person, Dr. Ross.
Thank you.
Very attractive, too. I don't know if I've ever told you that.
How do you feel now?
Like I could do things with you.
Well, that's obviously a strong pleasure terminal. The man is clearly turned on.
Will it tip him over, do you think?
Unless he were to receive multiple stimulations over a short time course.
Well, we've got him here for a couple of days. If anything seems wrong, we can switch to other electrodes.
I'm really very fond of you.
We better go to 32. Electrode 32, 5 and 5.
We can get on. Interface 9 and 31.
9 and 31.
You know, this really is amusing in a way. We're telling Benson's tiny computer how to work. It gets instructions from the big computer, which in turn gets its instructions from Gerhardt, who's got a bigger computer than all of them.
Is that right?
Be ready to induce an attack, Damaris.
Trust you gentlemen are ready. Mr. Benson. When you inject this into your neck muscle, you may feel a small twinge.
Been given 10 milligrams. It'll take a few seconds.
Seizure over.
It works. We've done it. Well, that's it then. I must be away, Arthur.
Okay, John. See you tonight.
Oh, yes.
See you tonight.
See you later, Harry.
Bye.
night, you can go celebrate.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can you monitor Benson on this computer?
You mean monitor the implanted unit?
Yes.
Sure, we can do that. I don't know why you want to. We know it's working.
I know, but would you do it anyway? As an extra precaution?
Yeah, we'll monitor. We'll run a check on him, what, twice an hour? All right, we'll run a check on him 4 times an hour.
Would you do it once every 10 minutes?
You got it.
Thanks for a great evening, John. A ball.
My pleasure, Jim.
And congratulations again. A real breakthrough. You're forever proud.
Thank you.
Robert?
I could put a wire in your head and pass a current to a specific part of your brain, and immediately you're going to ball me.
Great evening, Doctor.
My pleasure.
Yes, I must go too, John. Arthur? Wouldn't mind being in his shoes tonight, eh?
Oh.
Eddie's most likely screwing some nurse right now.
Going to stop the seizures.
It does. But if he has too many stimulations too fast, then the shocks alone will push him into it.
Is that likely to happen?
Yeah, it is.
Wonderful. So the wrong wires have been hooked.
Could be. It could be the idea just doesn't work.
I'm having trouble monitoring Benson. I've lost him.
Jeez. Come on!
Evening, Doctor.
Officer, could you spare a second?
Holy shit. Where is he?
How long were you away from the door? How long were you away from the door?
His clothes are still here, everything except his shoes.
How long were you away from the door?
Look, Doc, I was only away for a couple of minutes. I just went out to get some cigarettes. The nurse said she'd keep her eye on things.
What's it now? You seem to be missing a patient. Would you call Dr. Ellis, Morris, and McPherson? They'll be at Ellis's home. Tell them Benson is missing and then get hospital security. Is it clear?
Yes, doctor.
He left everything, his shaving kit, his wallet, his keys. It's all here. He can't get far in a bathrobe and bandages. I just can't figure it out.
Did he make a phone call tonight?
Yes, he made one about 11, but I didn't think to listen.
I know.
Everything okay?
Everything's fine.
Looks good on you.
Thank you.
Did you get your tonsils out?
No, I had electrodes planted in my pleasure cells.
Where to?
Just not possible.
It is. They found his bathrobe in the supply room. He put on an orderly uniform, walked right out that front lobby.
But his head was covered with bandages. Somebody would notice.
He had a wig.
You're kidding. What was the color of his wig? Blonde. But he was dragged out of his skull on Thorazine.
They were all in his room. He wasn't taking them.
Jesus Christ.
Dr. Ross.
Ross here. That is absolutely confirmed. All right. Gerhardt has done a computer projection on Benson's stimulations. At 3:02 this morning, he will be receiving continuous stimulations. He'll tip over then.
Oh, God.
That's less than 2 hours from now.
Is something going to happen at 3:02?
We can't have got a taxi at this hour.
He rang someone.
I bet it was that girl. What girl? Angela Black. She brought some stuff into the hospital for him.
She worked in a strip joint. I think I got the name of that place somewhere.
We better check that out. And his house. And his office.
You think I should report this?
Not just yet.
Yes, but I...
Listen. You let him get away. Your chief's not going to be too pleased. Don't worry. We'll find him in time.
Benson have his own key?
No, yes.
If you don't mind my saying so, Doctor, you seem a little tense.
We have a time problem.
Well, this is where we do most of our work, Doctor. What do you think?
It's incredible.
This is an automated ping pong player, defense contract. I'm sure defense has other uses for it, if you know what I mean. You play ping pong, Doctor?
No. You know his girl, Angela Black?
No, I don't think so. Look at this. Now, the idea is for the robot to find the ramp, go up onto the platform, and knock over the box.
Did Benson work on this?
Oh, yes. Yes, he did.
Anybody home?
What happened?
One wife, three kids. House in Beverly Hills. Two air-conditioned cars, five in-laws. Church every Sunday. 30-foot yacht. A custom camper and a Honda motorbike, a pool. An untouched acre in California Pines. Life insurance. Sauna bath. One German shepherd, two piebald ponies, three Siamese cats, and a family plot at Forest Lawn Memorial Park. Sold to me in a wild moment by a before-need counselor. Vaping your wife and shooting at the neighbors doesn't quite fit the image. You ought to see where I live now.
I'll wait until you're better. When did your wife divorce you?
A year ago. Are you married?
Do you ever see your children?
No.
Why not?
I'm afraid it might happen when I'm with them.
You mean you might have one of your attacks?
That's right.
Jesus.
Well,
this is getting us nowhere.
Sexual.
Captain, may I? I could have had an APB out on this over an hour ago. Every cop car in this town could have had a picture of this nut. And I could have had the monkey back in his cage. He could be anywhere by now.
Harry. Harry?
Know what happened to her?
No. Don't know her name. No. Look, take good care of her, huh?
Give her a nice easy ride right into the hospital. I'll be with her all the way.
Good.
It's all been a mistake.
Shooting machine.
The computer might be wrong.
They're taking over, you know. They're changing us.
How?
I wonder what'll happen when he really flips.
Anyone can suffer brain damage, Captain. Even policemen.
Do you know that epilepsy used to be known as the sacred disease?
Yes.
How about that?
Have you ever been interested in the idea of God?
I was brought up as a Roman Catholic. But I find that all that ritual garbage doesn't have much point anymore. I've always been absorbed by death, though.
1 minute to go.
Once a Catholic, always a Catholic.
What was that? I don't know. It's been the wind. It's pretty freakish in these parts. Yeah. Look, I'll be in there as soon as I can. I want to be there when she starts talking.
Do you have a nightmare? Honey? Are you putting me on?
Says that the next attack is due at 6:35 a.m. That's if the other happened as projected. They're getting closer each time.
It's funny. I had a call yesterday from Minnesota. They have a professorship in neurosurgery to fill. Asked me if I was interested. Isn't that funny?
No.
I wonder if they'll call back today. I wouldn't like Minnesota. Too cold.
Now notice when he's past the stomach, he continues to stab. You can see the tears in the sheet. They continue out in a straight line. Now, in my book, that's perseveration. Automatic continuation of pointless movement. Like you were some kind of machine that kept going and going.
Doris Blankfort, B-L-A-N-K-F-O-R-T. Stage name Angela Black, 26 years old. Previously of this address. Just moved in here again this week.
It's clear that the killer had intercourse with her before the murder. We've got a blood type on the seminal fluid, and it's A-O.
What time did it happen?
Around 3 o'clock.
Goddamn computer's right.
We were proceeding routinely with the investigation when we found this dog tag in the bathroom. Apparently, he left it behind when washing up.
That only gives us 25 minutes till the next one.
I hope he's by himself.
They lost him completely.
What time is the next attack due?
About 10 minutes. My God, what a nightmare. Look, Ross went home to wash up and change. Why don't you do the same? He'll turn up somewhere.
I hope he's dead.
The sadness of death gives way to the bright promise of immortality. Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended. When the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, we gain an everlasting dwelling place in heaven. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
I need help, Father.
I will pray with you.
It's not good enough.
Get out. Get out. It's happening.
I'll stay with you. Christ will help us. Hold this with me.
Yes, I fell asleep. What? Has anything happened? I'll take a shower and I'll be right over.
Come at an inconvenient time.
No, not at all. Excuse me a moment, I'll put on some clothes.
He'll tip over again soon.
Do you know when?
A few minutes.
Oh, God.
I
Like a cup of coffee?
Are you angry?
Why would I be angry?
Because I ran away.
Why did you run away?
Are you alone here?
Yes, I am.
Is something the matter?
No, nothing's the matter.
You seem tense.
Well, I'm not. I'm not tense. For heaven's sakes, Harry, how did you find us?
I found out where everybody lives before the operations. Paranoia.
Would you sit down, huh? You know what's happening, Harry, don't you? The stimulations, they're overloading you, and you're just being pushed into seizures.
I know.
Come with me to the hospital. I know they can fix it, and you won't have any seizures anymore.
You want to fix me?
You're not well.
I feel fine.
Just a few hours ago at Angela's, you weren't feeling fine, Harry.
I don't remember that. My memory tapes have been erased. Static. I just get static.
Harry, don't do that. You're not a machine. That's,
kettle.
The kettle, I think.
Thank you.
We had 14,500 murders. We had 36,500 rapes. We had 306,500 cases of aggravated assault. Yes, I am. I'm good at numbers as well. Altogether, 250,000 cases of violence, and that doesn't include automobile deaths. A lot of violence is carried out with cars.
And you think these figures reflect physical brain damage?
In part, yes. One of the clues pointing to physical brain damage in a single individual is a history of repeated violence. Now, there are many examples. Charles Whitman, who killed 17 people in Texas, had a brain tumor and told his psychiatrist for months before that he was having feelings about climbing the tower and shooting people. Richard Speck, who killed 8 nurses, and Lee Harvey Oswald, both had records of repeated violence. Well, now, of course, those are famous cases, but there are 250,000 cases every year that are not famous. See, we're trying to correct this violent behavior with surgery. Now, I don't think that's a despicable thing. I think that's a noble goal and an important goal.
Isn't that mind control?
What do you call compulsory education through high school?
Okay, that's it, fellas. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Will you go away, please,
no.
And let me talk to him?
No, I
please!
Can't.
Harry?
You keep your head down.
Look, he's... He'll let me talk to him. He's not going to do anything. Harry, come back with me. You have to let me help you, Harry. I can't help you unless you let me help you.
You next.
Quit kidding around.